hit me high and right away. We be chasing our hearts till we end up falling. Young and alive, we were runaways in a wasted summer. Chemicals in a foreign car. We took a moment, made it last forever. We found love laying under the stars. Made in July in a wasted summer. In a wasted summer. In a wasted summer.
We'll be right back. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to week 2 of Collegiate Star League Hearthstone Division. I am Lucia here, and tonight I am joined by our guest caster, Eden.
How you doing? Good to be here.
And that would be Eden with 6 N's for anyone
six
out there
N's.
Wondering.
I just wanted to get a gamer tag that was as hard as possible for other people to use. So that's why I settled on 6 N's in a row.
You know, have you seen that, what is it? That, like, I don't know what it's called on, but you know where there's, like, hey, and then it's, like, one hey, it's friends, two hey's,
right.
You know? It's like that, right? It's like, okay, so 6 N's, like, what does that mean, Eden?
It started when I got onto Twitter, and I just kept adding ads until they let me have the name. And then I guess it makes sense to have all your things be the same as your Twitter. And, you know, I'm going to change it, but I just haven't. Because now it's too much work to change it, because it's not just, I have to change my Instagram, I have to change my Facebook fan page, I have to change everything. It's that, like, at true. This point, it's not worth it. At this point, it's just let people copy and paste it.
Yeah. All right. Now, want to tell us a little bit about the teams that are playing today?
Yes. First, we got two best of fives today. First up, we have St. John's University Team Red Storm versus Marist College Team Go Red Foxes. St. John's University, interesting fact, is the University of Phone Tap, who is a very strong player. But if you look at the player lists, you will see that Phone Tap is actually not playing today. So there's a little bit of trivia for anyone who's been following the season.
Yeah, Marist College is probably pretty happy to not see Phone Tap play, but these five players are pretty strong. They're regular roster, so we definitely expect to see a strong showing by them. Not to mention Phone Tap is their coordinator and will probably, you know, be in the background telling them exactly strategically what to do. So Marist College still have to be on their toes for the day.
Absolutely. St. John's University, yeah, that's right, is actually sort of, not really, our defending champs, having won the that spring tournament with the Collegiate Hearthstone
Indeed,
League.
Indeed, beating out, I believe it was University of California, Berkeley. So
that was a different patch, and number two, a long time ago, so it could, you know, it's anybody's game. Let's see where this goes. I am pretty much ready to go if you are ready to go.
Yep, we're just prepping the players to get started here.
Okay. First up, we have Sean Conway, 91, playing against Winston Jacom. And I've got them both added friends list. We're doing the thing where we set up, and then IOBS, and then UOBS. Because Blizzard, God bless Blizzard. This is what we do.
Yes, maybe one day. One day in the happy future, we will have
an actual OBS mode.
Yeah.
Blizzard, please. It would make sense for them to put it, like, have it ready for BlizzCon too, right?
Well, I mean, they have, you know, all the production quality there, so they don't really need anything in-game. Like, everything is on land, so it's very easy for them to set up, you know, whatever they want for that. They've got some cool animation stuff as well, I think. I don't know if you caught the games leading up to Worlds, the qualifiers, where, you know, they show the card on the side, it animates, so they've got all... I mean, come on, it's the people who do the graphics for the game, right? So they can do any kind of crazy stuff that they want.
Well, for now we're doing this thing where we, like, chop the screen out and then flip it upside down again. Why don't they just flip it upside down? Like, why? That would be the easiest fix. I'm not a programmer, so I don't know.
I don't know. It's hard to say.
Because that's the most annoying thing, is that you need two observers to turn the hand upside down. That's it. And it would be such an easy thing for them to do, right? Like,
I mean, I wonder
when they made the spectator mode client, they must have decided on purpose to make it upside down.
Oh, you know what I think it is? It's just essentially they wanted to keep everything the same, right? Because the way the cards line up, they're just facing downwards. Like, if you look at your opponent's hand with the back of the cards. So it was the easiest thing to do.
I know the words that you're saying. I just don't understand.
There are words coming out of your mouth, and I disagree with them.
I just don't understand the order of them.
Yeah.
Anyways. Do you have a class list? Like, so we can
no,
talk about that.
The, okay. No, the players...
It's just going to be a surprise.
Yeah, the way it works out is each team is allowed to play each class only one time.
Okay.
But, you know, they don't tell us ahead of time. They don't let each other know ahead of time.
Oh, crazy.
It's part of the strategy. This is only our second week of doing this.
Okay.
So, you know, we don't actually know. There's probably a lot of strategy involved in that, you know, neither of these teams have really, you know, maybe really thought about as the season goes on.
This is kind of a new format, hey? Which is nice.
Yeah.
Because Conquest has kind of been figured out. Like, last year of Standing was starting to get figured out before they changed to Conquest. So it's nice that we have new formats. Switch it up.
Right. And this is also pretty nice for, you know, individual players, because they might only be good on one or two classes. Like, these are all students in university or college. Like, they have probably more important things to do than play Hearthstone all day.
What?
So.
Like what? like what? Firebat didn't go to college, and look, he's doing great.
He is. He's doing fantastic.
Okay, so, oh, I just got a message.
So the game is underway here.
Oh,
we
it is
have
underway.
Winston.
Oh, okay, good.
JCOM, yeah. Bottom side for St. John's University.
So we've got a mage versus a priest.
Yep, up top we've got Sean for Marist College.
Looks like we got a mech mage.
Indeed. I mean, yeah, tempo decks are pretty popular nowadays. Unfortunately, with the patch, patron seems to still be a thing.
Patron is still kind of a thing, which is, I think, amazing.
I don't know if this is to everyone's dismay,
I don't think that it's really a thing. Like, we can talk about patron if we see a patron. But it looks like the priest is going to have a relatively straightforward path to victory here, picking up Shadow Word Pain. You actually don't see Shadow Word Pain that much anymore.
Yeah, I think for a while it wasn't really seen.
For a while, people were running zero.
Yeah.
Now you're starting to see one again. It's nice to go with Pyromancer, and it's nice to, what's the Warlock card? The Imp Gang boss, because you can kill the Imp Gang boss without leaving behind any imps.
Right, or you can kill an Acolyte of Pain. There's just, you know, a lot of these small cards. Obviously, Pain isn't really there to deal with a threat per se. It's more so from the perspective of, you know, there's just a card you don't really want to have on the board.
It kind of is to deal with, because as a priest, a lot of the times you have nothing to do on turn two. So even if you, like, get a Knife Juggler, it's still kind of good.
So here, there...
What do you think about playing Mirror Entity instead of playing the Tinkertown Naked?
On turn three,
that was,
yeah,
turn three.
A priest could have a Dark Cultist come out on turn three. They could have, you know, even the Shrinkmeister and Pyromancer. The Cleric, the priest can't kill off that easily either, because you saw he just used a Pain, so it's unlikely he has another one. So,
oh wow, punished.
I don't mind it, especially because, you know, Sean has both Mirror Entities in hand. And with that Shredder, maybe a couple other draws, he might be able to play that Tinkertown and get a spare part later.
Well, it's not just, and especially against Priest, it's not only the spare part, it's also getting it to 4 attack.
That
it's
is
like
true.
Actually so OP.
Yeah, I think the 4 attack is not as big of a deal at this point, just because you already saw the Shadow Word Pain come
right.
out. But obviously the Blackwing Corruptor is something, or, you know, as
and
we see
health,
here,
too.
Yeah. The
yeah.
Velens, you know, or the Twilight Guardian. All of these cards, right, are the ones where you're like, oh, hey, you know, it
okay.
would be nice if I had an extra health so that Northshire Cleric didn't kill me.
So it looks like the priest has managed to stabilize the board, and it's only turn... Ooh, oh my god, Blinktron. It's only turn 5. So this is going to be quite an uphill battle for Sean, because what does Mech Mage have to deal with large threats? Like, I don't think Sean's going to be running Polymorph. Like, you don't want to be using Burn on that Northshire. So the Northshire is going to sit, it's going to hit something, it's going to draw a card, and it's going to hit something, and it's going to draw a card, and it's never going to die.
Absolutely. Now, Winston is thinking about, you know, throwing out the Twilight Whelp for the Mirror Entity. That's the cheapest. If he has enough... Oh, wow.
But why wouldn't you lead with the Twilight Whelp?
Yeah, interesting.
Because what's he going to do with his extra mana? That was weird. Unless he's...
Yeah,
no, because
he's
still holding an Azure Drake, so it doesn't matter.
He's not going to hit either. He doesn't have any spells in hand, so he couldn't kill off the Wild Pyromancer, but Very surprised they're giving his opponent the Twilight Guardian.
Well, you know what it was? It was next level mind games, because he's going to get the Twilight Whelp to get value on this mirror entity.
Definitely.
It was a mind games. It was a mind game.
Totally. Like, why didn't I see that?
He doesn't have Twilight Whelp here, obviously, so I'm going to put mirror entity.
Yeah, why didn't I see that? But, you know, he could give your opponent the Shrinkmeister instead, right? Like, last turn, he could Shrinkmeister the Piloted Shredder and then trade the Northshire Cleric into it. That would have been, you know, a decent trade. The Cleric can heal back up to full health.
The Cleric doesn't really need to heal. I think as soon as you, like, because Mechmage doesn't have any comeback. Although it does have a Flame Strike, which is not a traditional Mechmage card. So, who knows?
Yeah, generally Mechmage, you just want to pack with as many threats as possible. You're definitely the aggressor. You're just like, let me play as many guys out as possible. And Flame Strike doesn't really fit into that scenario. Generally at this point, you know, you just want to get more threats out. Like, if you played a Dr. Boom there, you know, he can still kind of trade things off, or he can just go face and let the Anoritron soak up two hits.
I think that was the best Flame Strike he could have reasonably expected, and the game is still kind of over. Because, like, he has no pressure on board. He's got three damage on board. And no way to get through taunts or anything.
Yep.
So it's going to be tough. Oh, he should have played the Tinkertown first, because he could have had the plus health.
That is true. Or some other way. You always want to see what you get, right? And
it's a small sequencing mistake. And, you know, in this case, not punished.
Yeah. The Pyromancer is going to work out here just to get rid of that pesky Divine Shield. And also, at that point... Yeah, there's no way, unfortunately, to trade...
What are you Valens on?
Well, obviously, you Valens on your opponent. And then Shadow Ward Death.
You could Valens the Cultist or the...
No. You Valens his Tinkertown... And
that's
then Shadow Ward Death.
No,
just say it.
Because then you lose your pyro, don't you? Yeah, you lose. Lose your pyro. Oh, this is not a straight up Mechmage. This is like a weird Mechmage with like late game.
The Blinktron comes out and it
poison
looks
blade,
like
Poison Blade. Everybody
a
shut
charged
up.
A hammer.
Poison Blade.
Oh wow, this is interesting because the Death Rattle will apply. So. Afterwards, Priest will not be able to heal himself if he uses up his hammer.
Right.
So I'm thinking...
And then, check this out, he's got a board clear. With
indeed.
The Poison Blade gaining plus one attack.
Oh, wow.
And he didn't swing.
I think that was a mistake. He didn't realize, right? Like, when do you get a Poison Blade? And then, you know, when do you realize...
I don't know if you know this about me, but I love Rogue, and I played a Poison Blade Rogue.
But Sean playing a mage,
you know. Yeah, fair though.
Even I don't know. I don't care how many games of Blinktron you play, you're probably not going to remember, like, oh yeah, you know. You remember the combos, like, you know, your mana worm will grow, so if you play a spell, your mana worm gains an attack, and maybe that's lethal, right?
Even then, though, you should have hit face, right?
Yeah, probably. Maybe he's saving it up, you know, just let it build up, and then just keep going face.
Fireball Drake. I think you have to get Ronin down.
Yeah. He loses his tempo at this point, so I definitely think the Ronin should come down. And even after dealing with this Ronin, Winston, you know, he's still in a lot of danger because, like, he's very low on health. Yeah, that Drake, thankfully, is going to soak up a lot of damage. And so will the Wormrest Agent. Actually, no, there's no dragons in hand, so... Those missiles...
No, I think you still put it down. It's still got 4 health. Like, it'll still soak a few missiles.
Does he decide...
That's right, right?
Yeah, he could play both of them, even. At
heal
this
face,
point.
Put the agent down. I would put the agent down.
Yeah.
I think Shrinkmeister you can save for Cabal.
He's thinking of using the Holy Nova instead here. He's really freaked out about his health, but he knows his... Okay, his opponent has... 3 arcane missiles, right?
You know what? He could win. Because
which is
3
9...
arcane missiles is on average like 4 or 5 damage to face.
Yeah,
with
so
no
there's
other creature
9.
On board. So we'll say
plus
it's 4
the
damage,
fireball.
Plus the fireball. Plus
the
hero
weapon.
Power, plus the poison blade, which will gain another one.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
so...
So
actually could have it.
That is true. I mean, yeah, at this point, it's like, do you want to put a body out there to potentially soak, right? Or do you try to heal yourself for the three and...
Okay, so now on average, he's getting three face damage. He could win this, actually. It's not that far off. He's getting, on average, three face damage.
All right, let's go. Let's go.
He only needs two face damage, right? He only needs two face damage. He's got four, ten. Yeah, he only needs to hit.
And...
That's it! He got it! He did it! Oh my god.
What a weird game!
Lizard.
What a weird way
Lizard,
to do
what
it.
What is happening? He did it! Oh yeah. My god, he pulled it out. That's really brutal. That's a really tough way to lose.
For sure.
But shoutouts to Sean Conway for a pretty cool deck. Like, Mech Mage was the cancer deck for a couple months, but that one had Bling Chan, it had Ronin, so...
Yeah, and with
Ronin
less
did
people...
did the thing he was supposed to do. Ronin managed to dodge the mind control, and he shot him in the face a bunch of times.
Yeah, with people not running Patron as much, you know, Ronin isn't... Not so much Ronin being a liability, but the missile sort of just taking up space in your hand, right? So
right. We
can see now there's more decks coming up that are... essentially, you know, tweaked a little bit for things that are really strong but might not do well against Patron.
Oh, so. Wow. Okay, so Marist College gets first blood. Jumps out to a 1-0 lead.
Yeah, they definitely, you know, feel good about that, right? Like, you come out, you know, this is your first broadcast game.
And it's nice to get that kind of momentum, too, in that sort of, like, nail-biting, like...
Yeah. And, you know, your opponent... I mean, you know, with 3 arcane missiles, he was definitely going to get 2 to the face, so...
Yeah.
If he didn't, that would be pretty, you know, pretty ridiculous. Not to mention he'll probably have lethal the turn after, so it's not really a big deal, but really cool way, you know, just to see them win. And definitely, you know, for a team that, you know, playing against someone like St.Johns, like, you gotta be pretty freaked out. Like, they're the champions from the spring tournament, you know, they have phone tap, like, pretty much, you know, everyone's gonna know their players. So definitely that's, you know, getting a game down, it's like, you know what, it's fine, it's okay, you know. So what if they're... if they're popular, like, we can still do this.
That also goes both ways, though. Like, when you're coming in as the favorite, there's a lot more pressure on you to win. Like, when you're the underdog, basically nobody's expecting you to do well anyways, so.
Yeah, that's true. There is no pressure on you. So, just a couple seconds here. We are setting up.
I've just contacted RD Mayo.
Yeah, I want to call him Red Mayo, and actually, you know, it's like, but instead it's RDE
Mayo.
RDE Mayo
1.
Yeah, O-1? Yeah, O-1. Mayo 1, and then you can see it on the lineup page. It's like, there's Mayo, and then there's 0-1, and the O is round, and the 0, you know, is a little bit squished.
Right.
So, kind of see that.
And his opponent, a Sumerian. Good name.
Does it mean something? I don't actually...
Well, Sumeria was an ancient civilization.
Okay.
Do
you think he's actually from that region of the world?
It's like vaguely Middle Eastern.
Yeah, that's
maybe.
Not too crazy. I don't know. Can people really trace their lineage sort of back? You know, it's
we
like,
can sort of
oh,
fake
hey.
It,
oh,
like
that's
Alexander,
true.
Like Alexander the Great. Was like the Greeks kind of claim him, the Macedonians claim him. He's just like, because he was from so long ago, he was just sort of a thing.
All right. Looks like we're still trying to get these games set up, so we'll take a short break here, put on a bit of music, and when we are back, we'll be going into game 2 of St. John's University versus Marist. All right, and we are back here. The players just getting ready to start up here. As we mentioned before, we have a Sumerian who may or may not be from the...
He may or may not be an actual Sumerian.
Indeed, and against him from Mars College will be RDE Mayo. Right. Now, getting into game here, it looks like we will have a Sumerian on the Hunter versus RDE Mayo on Warrior.
He doesn't have his set.
Alright, so. Looks like a Sumerian getting a pretty good drop here. The Leper Gnome coming down immediately, letting his opponent know this is sort of a either a hybrid or mid-range, a hybrid or face hunter as opposed to a mid-range hunter. And look at that!
Oh man, do you see what I see?
I do see what you see. Oh boy.
Patron lives, baby. Patron lives. Man. Can't keep it down.
I don't even know what to say.
Alright, so he's gonna pull a secret. What secret do you think he's gonna pull?
Probably and freezing. Yeah.
Can I just say that was an amazing top deck with the Fiery War X?
Indeed. Because yeah, everything in his hand.
It is called the Fiery Win X for a reason.
Looks like it will be an explosive trap, so this is a very aggressive phase hunter. I think this will do pretty well, you know.
Oh, he didn't swing. Would you have swung at the Leper Gnome?
No. I think I would. That's pretty expensive. Right?
Yeah, but it's gonna hit you anyways. Like, you're gonna take the 3 damage from it anyways.
Yeah, but he can hit it with his Acolyte if he wanted to.
Yeah, so I guess he's banking on it not being...
Or he can pick something up, right? Yeah, the inner rage there, so...
He can have a lot of outs.
Yeah, he can hit the Mad Scientist. Or he could have gotten a Whirlwind, you know. A lot of possibilities here. Now,
so he knows it's not... snakes.
Yep. And Inner Rage should clear out the Leper Gnome. Will he swing here with the Acolyte? Looks
like. I don't
like
think so.
No.
If he was gonna swing, you would swing before the Belcher, right?
Definitely. Yeah.
So good hold. Which means actually that the explosive trap in his hand is dead, and he doesn't have any other traps because the second Mad Scientist didn't pull anything.
Yep, that is true. So just a very, very heavy, face-heavy hunter.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, do you think he has the time? Like, if he's like, almost stable.
Yeah. I guess no tempo patron coming out here. Gets the other Acolyte down. He knows, yeah, at this point.
Oh, weird.
He wanted the card draw, he also wanted to know it wasn't freezing, right?
And so. He also wanted to dodge hounds. So it's like, there's pros and cons there. I don't know if I would have hit the Acolyte first.
I think here, I'd play out the kill command, just play out the animal companion. The problem is, it's very awkward if he gets a huffer.
Are you gonna kill command face?
Absolutely.
What do you think about double companion? Or companion hero power.
I mean, you do want to weave in the damage. Actually, yeah, because it would be equivalent, right? Mm-hmm. Using the hero power and the kill command because it's just a difference of 2 damage. So actually weaving in the hero power there would be correct in that sense.
That's the one! That's the one you needed! Like, so bad.
I mean, he had the shield maiden. It wasn't, you know... So, like, things were terribly...
But this negates the explosive trap, because the explosive will do 2 and heal 3.
Yep, this is absolutely true. And I think at this point, you know, RDE Mayo has gotten to the point of stabilization. That's
it's
always
still
the kinda idea.
It's still kind of scary, though.
Yeah.
You don't feel safe here. You'll feel safe
You don't
you,
feel safe as Mayo, but you feel like you sort of ran out of steam as Sumerian. You know, you do have a while, right? But you really need to deal with that armorsmith. Unfortunately, there was just no. Well, actually, he could have played the animal companion and kill commanded the armor smith. It feels bad, obviously.
You know what? I think that's actually the right play because the armor smith is gonna gain more than 5 health.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, well, I mean, control warrior is supposed to be the counter to face hunter, so.
But what about patron control warrior?
Patron was actually the best counter to face hunter. That's what people figured out. Because when they refined patron with the extra shield slams with the extra shield blocks to cycle and then you fit in the shield slams, you can do the double armor smith whirlwind and you can gain like 20 armor in one turn and then face hunter is out.
Yep. I think at this point, it's pretty hopeless for Sumerian.
No, you roll a huffer, and then you...
Well, you trade...
the Argent Horse Rider.
You trade the Horse Rider into the Armorsmith, so at least that's taken care of. And then...
But I think you get a huffer. Ah, oh, Leok.
Okay.
The reason he lost is because he got 2 Leoks instead of 2 huffers, and I think everybody knows that.
Yeah.
Oh, I think it's a mistake to kill the Shield Maiden.
Well, the Shield Maiden would have killed off Leok. And...
Yeah, but... I think Leok dies anyways, right?
Ooh. With Dr. Boom out now...
You're not concerned about face health. You just... Like, the Hunter is not concerned about his own health. The Hunter is only concerned about the Warrior's health at this point.
Yeah, it was a little bit weird because it seemed like he, you know, cared. That was the only way we see that really being a thing.
Creeper.
So he's got the beast plus kill command. So next turn he's got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. He has 10 damage. He has 12, but you know, assuming that Red Mayo armor is up.
Which I hope he does.
Yeah, if he doesn't, I mean, he can see it on board, right? That's probably an explosive. He can count it up. He has 9 mana, so. Ooh.
Do you think he's gonna proc the trap? I think it's a mistake to proc the trap here.
Yeah, he's gonna make patrons.
Because you only get one patron. You can get another patron if you, like, proc it, so your armor goes down to 1, and then you shield slam your own patron.
Oh,
and then
that's
your armor
true.
Back up. But is that... That's not really worth doing, is it?
Yeah, especially... Because your 3-2 patron dies anyway, right? So you'd have to... You get a 3-1, a 3-3...
Yeah, no, you do the shield slam thing after.
Yeah.
But I don't think you should do it. I think it's just a bad thing to do.
And the Haunted Creeper now is going to be kind of a liability, right? Because that's 3 patrons right there.
He got him, right?
Yeah,
That's it. That's it.
Oh my god.
Oh, lord.
Oh, face hunter.
He might have overkill damage.
He does. I think... Yeah, he just needed one more. He just needed one more damage, right? The hero power...
No, I don't think he did. No, because... Oh, no, you're right.
Yeah, the hero power would have only done 2, so... One damage there was enough, and the Face Hunter makes it, and tying up the series 1-1.
Face Hunter got him. I think it was a weird hand.
Yeah, it looked like, you know,
it
was going to be okay.
Because it looked like he was stable, but low. And then...
I think the problem is he had no more taunts, right? It was just all his shields. He got his shield maiden out, he got... I'm wondering if he had the chance to weave in another hero power in there somewhere. You know, because he played his shield maiden, but he wasn't going to die that turn, I don't think. So.
I think he missed the chance to get more armor off his armor smith.
Yeah, it could be that as well.
I think he could have procced the explosive trap with the armor smith on board. And that would have negated it.
Didn't he?
No, he traded his armorsmith in. Right?
I don't think
okay,
so.
Now,
so I remember,
I feel like
I remember the armorsmith at 2 health. So, something must have happened.
Well, With the top deck, quick shot, he was gonna lose regardless.
Yeah, absolutely. He would have needed like two extra armor ups in there. And
because he did have the option
to find.
He had the option to not proc the trap.
Yeah, maybe, but I think even then it's very hard to. Well, you know, if you armor up every turn, right, then it negates that. Then Hunter has to find that extra bit of damage.
Yeah. But it turns out he found it anyways, so sometimes there's nothing you can do.
Yeah, unfortunately, after all that...
After all that, we're even Stevens.
Yep, Face Hunter making it through.
It did it.
Now, series is tied up 1-1. We're moving on to game 3, Rachovski.
Looks like we're going straight into it.
Yeah, versus Crazy Barnacles. Now, there's a name I can get behind.
Crazy Barnacles and Rachovski.
Yep. And we have Rachovski here on the Paladin versus Barnacles on the Priest. Now, Barnacles not generally a name I would associate with a priest. What's a Barnacle kind of class to play?
What would a Barnacle class be? I don't know. I'm thinking of like SpongeBob SquarePants.
It's like, imagine yourself as a barnacle. Now imagine yourself as a barnacle who's playing Hearthstone.
Okay, so check this out. We got Dragon Priest versus Secret Paladin.
So both of these decks, you know, basically new decks that have come out after TGT.
I think with this hand, though, the Priest is quite a bit favored.
Oh yeah, absolutely. That's a killer curve.
Yeah, unless we can get into Dr. Six. Then it's anybody's game.
Even but with the Dr. Six, like looking at this is a killer hand.
Well, he's got what do you call it? He's got the Blessing of Kings coming up, which is going to help.
It's going to help, yeah. I'm curious why he hit the Worm Rust.
I would play the Blackwing.
Yeah, I think it's just good to get more creatures on the board.
Because you want more creatures to hit small creatures. You don't want a big creature, because that damage is overkill damage anyways.
Yeah, and if he doesn't play... he can't play his Twilight Guardian for the taunt.
Right.
Right, so... And this also kind of... I don't... Rachovski is playing really fast, so I don't know if he did this intentionally, but... You know, hitting there actually worked out, right?
Oh yeah, I would have hit. I think you
because the priest can heal up.
It has four charges, and you don't care about your own health as the paladin, so you just keep swinging.
I think you kind of have to care a little bit here, like
not on turn
usually,
four.
Well, when like, do you start caring, right? It's like
you
here's
gotta get
a
through, you gotta get through.
Yeah.
No, I think it's fine to swing there.
Pretty lucky there for Barnacles to pick up the Cleric. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, would be floating a mana there. Or I guess there's the Holy Smite, but there wasn't anything to clear at that point.
Play Secrets from hand. This feels bad. Repentance is good against Dragon Priest, though. So many of your creatures have big bodies.
Yeah, you're sort of hoping... That Barnacles doesn't pick up a dragon, because that almost means he would play out the Twilight Guardian, right?
So it looks like he's bluffing Avenge or a Noble Sack.
It's interesting that he went for the hit there, right? It's like a free...
Draw? Yeah, but it costs 2 mana. It's a tempo thing, right?
It is, but, you know, if he's gonna clear... Ooh, is he gonna clear... Yeah, he didn't play Redemption. So, that'll work out, possibly.
Did you play the Whelp? I played the Whelp.
Yeah, I think you play the Whelp, and then you try to hit in with... What do you try to hit?
Okay, that's correct.
So he's gonna
he holds
smite
first, because if it's Avenged, then you can clear it with the Blackwing.
Yeah.
But I think you should have played the Twilight Whelp first. Oh no, this is still correct. Or it's equivalent anyways.
Yeah, it works out. Yep. The only problem is that would not have played against Around Redemption, which Rochofsky had in hand. But when someone plays a mini-bot and hero powers, you're like, it can't be Redemption. It's too easy for you to just, you know, hit the clear the mini-bot shield and then hit the 1-1. It would have been like pretty good mind games if you did that.
This is a really sad Blessing of Kings. You never want to do this when you're playing Paladin.
Alright, with no secrets up, that Twilight Guardian can come down. I definitely play that.
I would play that before the Azure Drake.
Yeah. He could play the Holy Nova.
Draw first, right? Heal first. Would you Holy Nova? Draw two, trade in.
I think it's okay. I don't think...
Oh, what? Yeah, no, he totally could have saved his Blackwing if he wanted to. It's not the worst.
Well, the Blackwing only has 5 health. It wasn't buffed at all, so...
Oh, the Blackwing would die. Right. No, but he could have put the... Oh, no, he didn't have it. Okay. Sorry, I'm talking crazy.
All good, all good. Yeah, and at that point, you know, you might as well just go face with the Twilight Guardian there to soak up any damage. Now, would you go for the Mysterious Challenger or Dr. Boom here?
I think you slam Boom, right?
I think, yeah, generally if you
turn
if you
7,
can,
you just put on a Dr. Boom.
If you can play Boom, you play Boom. And he only plays... See... I think this is a wrong ordering. If he was going to play Redemption, he should play Redemption first.
So that you can redeem your own Mysterious Challenger.
No, I just mean in terms of whether your opponent would figure out what secret you had in hand, right? I guess all 4 secrets are up anyway. It doesn't really matter.
Whoa, what? Is that right? No, I think you hit first. Because that negates the Avenge. You should have swung first, because then you get the Noble Sack.
You get the... Yeah, you hit, you get the Noble Sack. Yeah, that's right. You're right, so...
You should have hit first. Although that's a very small thing.
Is the...
Because the Avenge would go on to one of the 2 big ones. And then the Redemption would have been on the Noble Sack. Which would have got caught up in the light bomb.
Yeah.
Which, yeah, so the unproxed.
And I think, yeah, there was a misplay there as well. I think you should have... It was supposed to be the cleric going face, right? And then trading into... Yeah, his 3-1 technician wanted to go into the 4-3 avenged guy. But... Instead.
Yeah, these are very small differences, though. Like, he's at 30 health. He's already got through one of the one rotation of secrets. Like, he's just got to grind them out now. Like, it's less than optimal, but it's not a big deal.
That's the thing, you know. Like, a lot of times you're like, oh my god, this guy misplayed. But with the state of the game, unless you're playing something like Face Hunter, it usually doesn't matter.
You just play it safe. And the reason, another reason for playing Dr. Boom on 7 is that on this turn he could have had Mysterious Challenger, Knife Juggler, or Mysterious Challenger, Hero Power. It just like fits the curve nicer.
Yeah, definitely.
Now he's floating a mana.
Well, if he got really lucky, depending if he plays Tyrion, he could have Tyrion this turn, and then Knife Juggled played Dr. Boom next turn.
That's true.
Value.
God top deck.
Yeah, unfortunately didn't happen, so Barnacles here.
Do you swing? No, you don't swing. Okay. Would I Holy Nova? No, yes, no.
He's just gonna steal a bomb. It's like, why not?
Okay, that's fair enough. Do you clear the other bomb? Apparently not.
So,
I think it's a bit scary to not clear that bomb.
Yeah.
Especially knowing that the last secret is Competitive Spirit, right?
Right, because that came out with the Mysterious Challenger, so he would have known that was the only one left.
That bomb.
Underwhelming, to say the least. Yeah, the Consecrate. Definitely expect to see here. And then Coghammer can take out the Cleric. And I think you could just go face with the Doctor.
Definitely just go face. Yeah, definitely. Creeper or Juggler? Creeper. Because I think you can get that Juggler value next turn. Where you like pop your own Creeper and get two knives.
Yeah.
Whoa. You definitely want the Divine Shield on the big one. Okay.
Well, guess he doesn't get to choose anyways.
Did he want the Divine Shield on the little one?
I would have taken out the Cleric instead. You're letting your opponent draw cards, and he has to get through the Divine Shield anyway, right? So
yes, this is madness.
Like even
Holy Nova?
Yeah, even with Holy Nova.
Oh my God, the top decks are real. The top decks are real.
Kills off the knife, yeah.
Okay.
I mean,
so
at this point. Yeah,
Taladin's in trouble. That was a really big top deck, man. He still had a chance.
Absolutely. I mean, think about this, right? If Barnacles didn't have the Azure Drake, he probably, you know, might have tried just healing the Cleric, seeing what he drew. Actually, he has two Azure Drakes, right? So,
right.
But
and then get the
yeah,
get the,
and then
yeah,
in
anyways.
That case, right? You know, you're like, oh, he wouldn't have gotten it.
Well, with the Holy Nova in hand, and the Balins on top of that.
Yeah.
Oh my God, he throws out the BM. The light will burn you. And he became a level 40 priest.
Oh, how about that? Congratulations to Barnacles.
Yeah.
Making it to level 40 as priest.
What do you get? You get a gold... It's a neutral card, isn't it?
I don't remember.
I don't know.
I don't think anybody remembers, actually.
It was like 2 years ago for me.
I'm like, anybody... That's not something you remember. That's like, what? No. That's not a thing.
One of the golden ones for leveling up is Senjin Shieldmaster. I remember that because I really wanted it.
And then Senjin didn't really get played anymore. And then you were very sad.
Senjin's still good. It's just that Belcher is clearly better.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if Belcher wasn't in the game, a lot of decks would still run Senjin. Right? Because Senjin is favorable against Piloted Shredder.
Yep. So it looks like next we have Dino Sam for St.Johns versus King of Lego. The score is up 2-1 for Marist College. So King of Lego here going to show us if he is the King of Hearthstone as well. Har har.
Ooh. Let's see if I can find him. I just looked this up, and the reward for level 40 priest is a golden Northshire cleric.
Oh wow, that's definitely,
yeah. Yeah, which is actually very fitting because Northshire cleric like carried him that game.
Basically, yeah.
Just killing nerds and drawing cards.
Indeed. All right, so our next game coming up. Wonder if Phone Tap, you know, he's coordinating this, so he's watching as the games go by. You know, maybe he's like, oh man, I should have played, you know, why did I let my teammates play?
Oh, come on, it's 2-1.
Yeah. We'll see. Maybe Dino Sam can take it back, even it out for the two schools, or King of Lego going to, for me, I think of it like, King of Lego kills someone by, like, putting, you know, like, you kill him down, get him down to one health, and then just, like, put a piece of Lego where his foot's gonna stand, and then he just stomps down on it and just, like, kills himself, and you're like, that is how you die by Lego.
Oh, mid-range. No? Maybe? Maybe it's a mid-range pally.
I think that's pretty suitable, right? Paladin gets all these 1-1 guys, so that's sort of like Legos. That's the closest hero power you would get to Legos,
that's
I think.
A stretch.
Oh, come on!
What about the warrior armor up, where it's like stacking Legos?
No, I don't think so. Because it's their building pieces, right? And with Paladin, you know, with Blessing of Kings, with Coghammer, like, you're building on top of those guys. Come on.
Okay.
Come on.
I agree. I thought about it and I agree. Can you get Dino Sam to invite me? I don't think I have him.
Sure, give me one moment. So it looks like we've
Oh my
got
God, what is this druid doing?
the Cancer Druid.
What is that doing in your deck? So what is this? Like where you get like Living Roots and then you get the 1/1 tokens and then you Savage Roar them and
Yeah, absolutely.
he whiffed on two, hey?
Yeah, that's unfortunate. If you could have gotten a Living Roots or something,
Or an actual two drop, yeah.
Yeah. Well, the Living Roots I say specifically because next turn he has the Savage Roar, and you can Savage Roar now, right, and get the same value as you would with just a Force of Nature. So, as a tempo play, when it might be okay as well, you know.
3 mana, 8 damage, baby. Get him. Yeah, so he really needed that 2-drop last turn.
Yeah, that's the problem when you play tempo decks like this. It's like if you miss, you know,
Whoa, is he going all in?
it hurts a lot.
Whoa, crazy. Would you trade there? Like, what are you scared of on five? As the paladin.
Normally, a Druid of the Claw. I guess you would still play it as Altair because you could, you know, change it to charge and combo it with Savage. So, yeah, I think it's fine to trade it off. There was no. You know, it's not like he has a quartermaster or something in hand. If that was the case, then maybe you don't
Right.
trade, but.
There's a threat of it. I guess whatever, because the paladin is clearly going to be the control deck,
The
so
other
it's fine.
thing, right, is if Altair had a swipe, then you lose all your guys anyway, so you might as
Right.
well trade them in as soon as you can.
I guess so. It's fine. Whoa, whoa, what? I would have played the Shredder for sure. Right, you get a 4/1 and a 4/3 Shredder.
I think he just wants to play very cautiously. He
That's clearly better.
knows in late game he's going to be totally fine, like with Tyrion, with the Eldors. So I guess he's just trying to play as carefully as possible, and especially against a druid. He doesn't have the mana to do it yet, right? But leaving more guys on. Well, actually, double Savage Roar or something like that. Like, you just don't want to leave your opponent with guys on the board, you know, for the Savage Roar combo. All right. Let's see. He only gets one juggle. Or maybe if that, yep, yeah, it dies. Okay. Now, what do you hit here? Looks like a bit of technical difficulty. I seem to have lost my co-caster.
Hey, are we back?
And
We're
he's
back.
back.
We're
You're
back.
back. I was
Okay,
never
I'm
gone.
back.
Come on.
Well, I don't want to fight in front of the children, okay? But a
What?
relationship takes work from both people.
Calling them children. And look, that's.
That's not lethal, is it?
No, I don't think
I will cry
so.
if it's lethal. It's not lethal. It is lethal if he has the other
Yeah. But that's why
one.
this is why you don't want to leave guys on board. Eldor, usually you're like, you know what, I feel pretty safe here.
Right.
But something that gets Eldor can still get savaged. Alright, clearing off. Do you hit with the shade here? I think, yeah, at 4 health. Well, he could still get True Silvered, but he saw that his opponent already used one. And another Eldor coming down. Coghammer up. He has Tyrion next
Please.
turn, so he. It's.
Yeah,
We
but
run into another situation where it's like, you know, is
I
it.
don't think that's good enough. Is
Ooh!
it good enough? He's
Let's
dead
see
to 8
here.
damage. So that is a Savage Roar. Although not really with the way
No, yeah, because there's a Divine Shield,
yeah, because the Divine
so.
Shield works out.
His face. No, but he has six. 7, 8. So if the knife of the shade hits hits it, right, then he can trade something in 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. No, even, yeah, he would not have enough. But I think you go for it anyway here. Just because it lines up well. Actually, no.
I think hero power.
I think, yeah, okay. You hero power. Because you have the Savage Combatant, yeah, you hit that in, and then you use your face to clear it, and then you go face. And then as long as your opponent can't clear too many things, because he has to know, right? Turn 8 is Tarion turn, so he definitely want to save the Savage Roar if possible.
Right.
And even with 8 health, you know, it's very hard for the Paladin to muster 8 damage with nothing on board. He doesn't have charge, so I think this is it. Yeah, with the Savage Roar.
This is it.
I think he would have had enough even if he didn't save his Savage Roar, right?
Got him! Savage Roar, 3 mana, 12 damage, good card. Just hit him in the face.
Oh, yeah, he can do the BM, because he has 7 health, right? So he can hit his face into Tyrion. Yeah. A little bit scary, but, you know, could definitely do it. So that will be Dino Sam taking the game with the Druid.
So we're going to an ace match!
Yep.
Ace match!
I feel like this is the moment I want to interview Phone Tap and be like, do you really... Because you know by game 5, right? If you get to play, then if you get to play, then that's when your team is like 2-2, right? And in that case, it's like, well, I should probably play and give my team the highest chance to win.
Hey, what about Johnny Boy? You don't know about Johnny Boy. What if he's a dark horse?
Yeah, maybe. I mean, like I said, all 5 of those players, their team for the tournament, I think, had 6 players.
Oh my god, check this out, everybody. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
Oh god.
The ace player for Marist College is Chez96, which leads me to believe that this man was born in 1996 and is in college. And I just feel like an old person now.
Yeah, I mean, okay, that would mean he is 19, right?
That's crazy.
That's college age.
How can you... But 1996, man, that's like...
Sean Conway is 91. We should be asking why he's still in college. 24? Yeah, that's like... That's at the top end. You know, that's the team.
He's probably a grad student.
Maybe this was like a grad... You know, you start with your oldest player at Sean Conway 91, all the way down to your youngest player at Shay 96. Yeah, there's one in between. Clearly these players are lined up by age.
What was happening in 1996? Atlanta, Georgia had the Olympic Games. Okay. What year did Pokemon launch? I think this kid is younger than Pokemon.
Oh dear.
That can't be true.
No, you don't want to go down that path. Then you start realizing all these things have come out and all these kids have grown up and then you just start feeling old. So that is not the path that we want to go down.
John and Boy.
All right, just getting into game here. And here we go, the ace match between St. John's versus Marist College.
First Warlock of the day.
Indeed.
This is exciting. I was expecting to see more Warlock. Warlock's a good deck.
It is.
A good class. It's got a ton of good decks.
Well, I think Zoo has kind of just fallen
Zoo,
off.
Hancock. Well, Zoo fell off because of Patron, right? Because like all those little dudes were a liability.
Oh, that's true,
but
yeah.
With Patron gone, Zoo, I think, is just a good deck.
I don't think... Yeah, that's pretty surprising to not see the Zoos making a comeback.
Anyways, we got a dragon warlock, but there's so many good warlocks. You're like demon lock, you got hand lock, dream steed.
Oh god, I played a game as druid against a dreadsteed deck, and it literally came
it's
down
really good.
It came down to I was drawing my like I needed a set of trees to win, right? I had double savage and like innervate and hand. I just needed my force of nature were two of the last three cards I had in my deck, literally. What card did I? Oh right, it was a. I killed his Thorson to pull out my last minion to guarantee that I had the force of nature the next turn, or he would have been able to kill me because he had Mal'Ganis and a board of dreadsteeds.
Right.
So, that was a very clutch game.
Check this out. Blast from the Past. Oh, Undertaker. It's back.
Have you much experience with the Dragon Warlock?
I've played it. The idea is control the board, stay alive, and then you play a Thorson with Soulfire, Dark Bomb in your hand, or Malagos in your hand, some combination of those cards.
Right.
And then you drop Malagos, and then you shoot him in the face a bunch of times. And then you hope that your Soulfire doesn't discard your other Soulfire.
Yes. There is
But in the early game, it plays a lot like traditional Handlock, where you tap and you get your big Twilight Drake, and you can taunt up. There's a lot of cool pros and cons for it.
Yeah, I'm surprised Johnny Boy didn't kill off one of the imps, which will let him...
Punished!
Yep.
Although he maybe thought it was... No, he didn't think it was Handlock. Maybe he did think it was Handlock.
There's just no reason not... If he thinks it's Handlock, then again,
there's
he
no
shouldn't...
reason to not do it.
Yeah, he shouldn't be hitting face, right? So...
Corruptor value.
Yeah, I mean, he can kill off the Yeti. He wanted to. Instead, he's going to play the Azure Drake. Gets a Dark Bomb. That's one out of three pieces he needs there.
Did he just want to cycle there? Because why not play the Corruptor?
Well, if he plays the Corruptor...
This is a really weird mage.
The Drake trades into it, so...
Yeah, but the Drake trade... I don't know, but now the Yeti hits the Drake.
No, the Yeti goes face, the flame cannon.
Right. But I mean, he didn't know that. Like, I'm just talking about on board. I'm not sure how I feel about this.
So this way, at least a Yeti has to... He's thinking at least a Yeti has to trade into it, but... Another Azure Drake comes out, and the Frostbolt is going to take care of that. He's thinking about trading, though. He's afraid this is a hand... He knows it's a dragon. Warlocks don't run...
Because...
Yeah, they don't run Moltons, right? I don't think there's any reason not to keep these guys up. They have 5 health. They're not going to die to anything, you know, like an... Even if he had, like, an Ancient Watcher Shadow Flame, like, there's still... Oh, wow, he is going to keep him healthy. That's interesting. He's afraid of Moltons.
The Yetis are crazy, though. The Yetis are definitely for the spare parts, right? To go with Antonitis or the Flame Waker.
Well, they're good solid drops as well. Yeah.
Yeah. But you just don't see Yeti that often anymore.
For sure. I mean, they go... Yeah, there's the Flame Waker shots.
Is the game over? He has a chance to win, right? I think you just win.
Well, he didn't hit. He didn't hit last time.
No. But you have a shot to win now, so you definitely do that. Because you either clear the Drake or you win. But... Oh, yeah, you definitely do that.
I'm surprised he didn't hit last turn. I guess he just wanted to play it really safe, but... Oh, Ragnaros apparently doesn't like face, so Razor has
Twisting
one more
Nether.
Shot.
Oh my god, what? Twisting Nether.
Well, that's why you don't play Spellslinger, right? You don't want your opponent to get a Twisting Nether.
I think Twisting Nether is the only out, right?
Well, he can't play it. He can't tap and get it now because he doesn't have enough mana.
Yeah, he can't get it. It's also not in his deck.
Okay, well, you don't know that for sure.
You don't know that.
You don't know that. You don't know me.
You don't know me.
Oh boy. Yeah, you don't know these kids, you know, born in the 96s.
I think he's
play
just
all
going
kinds
on
of crazy cards in his
but
deck.
I think that's it. Like, I don't there's no out, right? You can heal bot, that'll get you to 14. And then,
well, you've got a sludge.
What you can do is heal bot Imp Gang boss and then hope that the Imp Gang boss tanks the Ragnaros hit. And I think that's the absolute best play. So now
or
you spell slinger for a fireball, easy, right? You just spell slinger into tracking into fireball, and then you're like, wow, this.
Yeah,
game's
but
easy.
I'm telling you, man, spell slinger, you'll give your opponent the twisting nethers, and then
it
you wish
matter.
You didn't spell slinger. Hunter's mark, not really what he needed.
It was almost the tracking. Hunter's mark is pretty much the same as tracking.
Oh wait, does he? Okay, so he can. Hunter's mark the Imp Gang boss.
Hunter's mark his face. Oh no.
He can Hunter's mark the Imp Gang boss.
Hunter's mark the Imp Gang boss and then ping it?
Hold on. He can do this.
He doesn't have lethal though.
He does. Yeah, with counterspell, right? So
it kills off. Oh, sick!
There we go. It kills off the minion, and then...
Oh, sick!
That's a great way to end the game.
That was actually really sexy lethal.
Absolutely. And there we go. Johnny Boy, not disappointing, showing us, you know... St.
John's,
they are good to go. They don't need phone tap. Phone tap can go.
That one out. And that was a nice
whatever.
Finish, too.
Absolutely.
Especially for an ace match. Yeah, get some drama in there.
There were some pretty nice games. Like, pretty, you know... Nice finishes. Actually, you weren't here on Wednesday, but we had a game. Well, actually, the last game. It was a 3-0, and it was a BM gone wrong by the losing
yes.
team.
Yes. Somebody sent it into Trollden, because these people should be famous.
It was the revenge proc'd a piloted Shredder, and then it proc'd a... taunt, which then did not allow his opponent to get the lethal and then died. Do not BM, boys and girls. That is the lesson of the
day. There's some really weird things that can happen with, like, True Silver Champion for a BM, too. Like, one time I had a True Silver Champion with a...
Oh, like a Shadow Boxer?
Yeah, Shadow Boxer, and then the Shadow Boxer boxed the thing that I was gonna True Silver, so I healed, and then the thing died. And then I got to heal again.
Huh. What?
So I healed, but I didn't attack.
Oh, interesting.
So it didn't use the charge. And then you get to attack again and heal again.
Yeah. There's other weird things, too. Like, you True Silver to hit their Light Warden, and then it heals you first, and then it hits the Light Warden. So you take two damage. So, you know, just all kinds of weird stuff happening.
There's also, like, you can, like, True Silver back from the dead against an explosive trap. Like, you can go down to zero and then back up.
Oh!
Yeah.
That sounds like fun. Alright, so we're gonna take a quick break here, and when we are back, we will bring you the second series of tonight, which will be University of California Santa Cruz versus University of North Texas. Don't go anywhere.
We'll be right back!
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Collegiate Star League Hearthstone Division. I am Lucia Fireball, and with me is Eden for today.
How you doing? Good to hear from you again.
Yeah, it's like, maybe my co-caster ran off in the 5 minutes, and I am now stranded here by myself.
I almost forgot to unmute, so got my mute APM up.
Yeah, that would have been like, oh no, where did my co-caster go?
Still here, baby.
All right, so for our second series here today, we've got University of California Santa Cruz versus University of North Texas.
Yeah, let's talk about this. I just want to say shout outs to University of North Texas for getting a sweet name as the UNT Eagles. UCSCHS, kind of a mouthful. Not that exciting. Not as intimidating.
I agree. I think there was Princeton. They called themselves the, what was it? Only Face Hunter? Something like, they had like an actual name.
Only Face.
Like, only play Hunter, or some Hunter only. But it's like the only team that I thought, you know, had a proper name. But UC Santa Cruz makes it back because they have a slug for their mascot. How many schools can say that?
I did not know that.
All right.
What kind of slug?
There's like different kinds of slugs.
A slug of cultural significance? That's what I mean. Like,
I don't know
much about the slugs of California.
I guess I have to agree with you there. I too do not have
like
enough.
Sort of Californian banana slug. I'm not a slug expert, so.
Mm-hmm. All right, so we have the game underway here between the Wandering Penny and Fury. Now, fun fact, in Canada, we have gotten rid of the penny. So
we did. It's been about a year and a half now.
Yeah. I guess the pennies have all wandered over to the States. And I guess they've made their long journey all the way to California by this point. And they're now playing Hearthstone.
That's why it took it so long, because it was on the back of a slug.
Yep.
Do you tap our Ancient Watcher here? Tap? I would have tapped. Come on.
It's a hunter.
What are you going to do with this watcher, though?
You're going to play two watchers, and then you're going to find a taunt, and then you're going to be pretty happy.
Yeah, but you don't have the taunt in your hand. Okay. Well, shows what
you
I know.
You have to be optimistic.
Shows what I know about this game.
You got to be optimistic. You can't just be like...
You tap now anyways, don't you?
No, you play your second Ancient Watcher.
Okay. To what? Soak up more knife juggles?
Sure, why not?
Okay, and the next turn you're going to tap. So I feel like you should just tapped on two. Because you would have got here. Right?
That's fair. Yeah, you would get here.
Okay, well, you definitely need to Sun Fury now. So do you tap this turn?
No, you play the Void Caller. What? You don't tap!
Wait, no, you gotta play the Sun Fury.
Yeah, I think you have to.
Because if you Void Caller, he pulls the Draxus, and then you're really sad. Right?
Well, you don't know, because then you have Draxus out, and then you Sun Fury, and that's 15 HP that the Hunter has to get through.
Right, you go like Molten, taunt the Draxus. That's really scary, though.
Yeah, I don't know. 17 damage is possible.
You know what? I think you're right. I think your play is better. But then why do you want the Watchers?
No, you want the Watchers! Leave the Watchers alone, man!
It doesn't make any sense.
Leave the Watchers alone. It's all planned.
I've never been great at Handlock.
I think Handlock is pretty cool. At first, I didn't really like it because it just felt really scary. Like, you're about to be dead
you're
all the time.
Yeah,
and I didn't really appreciate that. But once you sort of get over that hump, I think it's a pretty fun deck.
Yeah.
Alright.
Okay, do you go man mode?
What is man mode?
Void
I think color. I would have...
Because what can you die to? 10 damage, but he's only got 5 mana, so the worst he could do, he's got no beast, so the best he could do is like...
Play a beast, kill command, yeah, there's not enough. Kill
like,
command,
the
quick
best
shot?
He could do is like...
That's 6, 7,
Stone
8.
Tusk, Boar, Timberwolf, kill command, I think.
So I think Arcane Golem?
The Watcher.
Arcane Golem?
Oh, yeah,
plus
double Arcane
shot.
Golem is the best.
No, you can't double though, you only have 5.
Oh, you only have 5. Yeah, so... There's nothing you can die to. Like, Huffer Quickshot.
You can Animal Companion and...
I think that's the best you can do.
Oh, and Glaivezooka?
That's only 3 damage, though.
Yeah, 3,
the best you could
4,
do is,
5,
like,
6,
Huffer
7, 8, 9.
Double Arcane Shot, which is only 8.
Ha! Arcane Shot, that's a card. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Of course. How could I forget that?
Okay, so man mode.
You have to go man mode at this point.
Yeah. Because I think it's too late. I think he's going to die. You need to top deck a heal bot, right? You need to go like...
Well, no, he has the Molten and Taunt.
Defender. Yeah, but he's just going to get hero powered out.
Yeah, but he has a few turns. to wait for the heal bot. It's not...
He won't be able to get to Jiraxxus. And check this out. The real scary thing is that he's got Houndmasters, so it's not just a face hunter deck. He's got other plays.
You do not Hellfire. Oh, actually. Yeah, you don't have enough mana to Hellfire and Defender.
Yeah. No, you definitely don't Hellfire here.
Oh, come on. It's the greatest thing ever. Ooh, a second Defender. Okay. This might do it.
I don't think the second Defender matters. Unleash, right?
Unleash would
kill... Oh, you know what? The second Defender actually might matter if he pulls Jiraxxus.
Yeah, he's definitely going to pull Jiraxxus.
But he's still going to...
No, he needs to get through the Molten.
No, you just... Yeah. I think you just Hero Power Explosive Trap, right? So he can never hit you in the face.
Yes. He has to wait for a heal bot to be able to hit him in the face.
Yeah. Okay. Well.
I think that's... Yeah, you're right. That's the way to go.
Let's see how this plays out.
Anything you play is going to get cleared. Right, so, yeah. I think you're right. If you just Explosive... Yeah, the Haunted Creeper's fine.
Would you hold the Creeper or play the Creeper?
That's fine, you have Unleash the Hounds. I wouldn't play anything that lets the Void Caller kill itself, essentially. That's the only thing that matters.
So, you can't hit him in the face, because then you will lose. You can't tap. You can tap, but then if you don't...
You can... I would put the Void Caller in...
You have to tap into Anti-Keelbot, right? If...
Yeah, but you get another chance, right? So I would say put the Void Caller into the Mad Scientist, and then use the Argus to try onto the Creeper, and then you might get freezing up, right? And then you can pull your Argus back.
You should do Argus first, then.
No, because I want the Argus back. Yeah.
So you want. So you're banking on this first trap being explosive, and then you're trying to draw the freezing from the Mad Scientist.
Well,
that's next level, man. Oh, he did it! He did it! But I don't think it's gonna matter.
But I wouldn't hit here, because... Oh, no. Because he can trade... Yeah. I don't know. No, I wouldn't hit.
It doesn't matter.
Well, I guess, he doesn't wanna...
It doesn't matter.
Kill command doesn't matter. I wouldn't hit. The reason I wouldn't hit there is because this way he can trade his spiders into your Molten, and you still can't proc your Void Caller.
Right.
So I wouldn't hit there. Yeah.
But what is procing the Void Caller get you?
No, you don't want it to proc. So you can get the Jiraxxus out, right? So if you get a heal bot, then, life's pretty peachy at that point.
But you want to play Jiraxxus from hand, not have it on board, don't you?
Oh, I guess, at this point... That's true.
He's not going to make it. Do you think he's going to make it? He might make it.
See, he's trading them in. He doesn't want the Void Caller to get procced. That's
why he's scared of Mal'Ganis.
Wouldn't hit.
He doesn't know because he's scared of Mal'Ganis.
That's true. He can't play the Doomguard either.
This is it, right?
I think so.
There's no heal and he's going to die to the hero power.
We might as well Hellfire at this point. Oh, what happens if you have only Mal'Ganis in hand and you Hellfire here? It kills you first, right?
You die first.
Yeah, that's no fun. Yeah, if you don't have a heal,
you can't. Same for the explosive trap. Yeah, no, he's dead. Sucks.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Slam boom, I guess. What if the boom bots each do 15 damage? Oh, that's a really bad. See, I think you could have tapped on two. I really do, because you've been a couple cards deeper, right? Like, okay, hold on. Let's go back. When I said it was bad at
Handlock, God.
I was still a legend Handlock player.
Oh my God.
Okay, so I wasn't like...
Okay,
bad,
look.
Bad.
If you get, if you play whatever else to legend and you play one game of Handlock at legend and win, that doesn't make you a legend Handlock player.
No, okay? I am a legend Handlock player. I was just not competitive level Handlock player.
All right.
I was just, I don't know. I think I would have tapped.
I think if you play Handlock, then you tap. Right?
On two, I mean. Like, it's kind of crazy to... I don't know.
I don't think it makes a difference in this.
I would have to know his full list and stuff like that too. Mm-hmm. So I'm not even gonna call that a misplay. It just could be a deck building choice. It could just be play style. I'm just saying my own personal instinct is to tap on two.
I think that's every handlock's instinct, right? Mm. Alright, gonna go ahead and next game should be set up pretty quickly here. We've got Raycon versus Jacob.
I think it's Jacob 7.
But there's an O. So.
Jacobo?
Yeah.
Jacobot? Jacobo. Maybe it's Jacobot. Like the like Leetspeak, the 7 is a T.
Ah, yes. I like where we're going with this. That's a lot cooler than Jacobo 7. You know, you could be like Jacob 07, then you're like James Bond, right?
Jacobo is kind of like Chocobo, though, like from Final Fantasy.
Yeah, that's true. That could kind of work.
This is Raycon? Raycon?
Mm-hmm. So this is actually, fun fact, our first second series of the day that is not a match between two schools in the same state. I think the first night we had we had two schools from Dakota, from South Dakota to be specific, Dakota State versus South Dakota. Second night, we had two schools from Michigan, I believe. Third night, it was two schools in California. And now we have University of California Santa Cruz versus University of North Texas.
There we go. We're diversifying our geography. Mm-hmm. I've been to South Dakota, just random fact.
How is it there?
I saw Mount Rushmore.
Oh, cool.
And there was a giant motorcycle rally.
Okay.
And it traumatized my, like, conservative Chinese parents.
Ah.
Yeah. I think I was, like, only, like, 14 or 15.
Hmm.
We randomly went on a family road trip to South Dakota, like, from Alberta.
Just to South Dakota. Actually, yeah, that's pretty close, right?
It's not super close. It's more than one day. But yeah, no, just like traumatized my parents. Good times.
Oh dear.
All right, let's
I cannot.
I'm just talking nonsense because I can't handle.
I was really trying to, you know, make conversation there with you, but after the traumatized Asian parents part, I'm just like, yeah.
I'm sure you can relate.
That's I don't think my parents are terribly traumatized by anything.
Well, yeah. Have you tried getting pregnant?
No, I have not.
Do that for April Fools.
It probably would.
Don't actually get pregnant, but just tell them you are for April Fools and see what happens.
No, I'm quite all right. I will definitely decline.
Well, you're saying you totally could.
I could. There are a lot of things I could do in life. But that would not be one that will actually be occurring.
Oh, okay.
All right, we've got the second game here.
I was looking for Jacobo, but his battle tag is Narcidius.
Indeed.
Which definitely threw me off.
That slug, though, especially, the one in the in-game screen looks all happy and friendly and is holding a book. But the one in the video, the intro video, actually looks really manly and buff, and he's got his arms crossed and looks really mean. So I'm really digging. I think if there was like, if there was there has to. We need two awards at the end. One for best school mascot, and one for best team name. And I'm absolutely nominating UCSC for the best mascot award.
I haven't seen all the mascots yet, so I can't judge, but I do quite like it. Yes. I need to leave this game because I think my spectator glitched.
Indeed, there's a hole. There's a wild growth, an ancient of war, and a mysterious hole where there should be
mine
a
card. Was a floating card.
Okay.
Thanks, Blizzard.
Well, I think
okay, we're back. We're back.
They so fixed up spectator.
Looks like
mode
mysterious
sound.
Drew a wild growth, and it looks like Henry the 10th drew a Darnassus. So.
And was the floating card? Yeah, the floating card was the Sludge Belcher. Mm. Right, and so here we go. Kind of an interesting dynamic here. We have Narcidius with very few cards left in hand, and Henry.
I think he's got enough though. He's got a 5, 6, 7. That's enough, right?
Definitely the 6 that you want.
It's not the 6 that you want, but you can like. By the time he gets there, he'll have 2 more cards. So like a lot of things can happen between now and then. And even then, it's not the worst thing. Like if you're on curve, you can still slam it down.
And Henry X, despite having 7 cards in hand, does not have a play for turn 3.
Crazy.
No wild growths for him either. He had the Darnassus, but that got taken out, so
that was a good play to charge to innervate the Druid of the Claw charge form. Sorry, that was a mouthful. Yeah, it totally paid off because otherwise the Shredder would have come down this turn and then Narcidius slash Jacob.
Do you play the Sylvanas here or do you innervate coin the ancient? You don't play the Shredder because...
So the thing about Druid is that you want to follow your curve as much as possible, but with the Belcher down here, yeah, you definitely don't want to play the Shredder, which just gets cleared for free. If you innervate Sylvanas, what do you do on 5, right? You don't really have a 5. If you innervate coin Ancient of Lords, not as... you're still kind of screwed on 5. Like, you could still Shredder on 5, I guess.
I mean, this way he can innervate.
I don't love this play, though. Look at this! He got a 6! Sick top deck.
That is a 6. That is quite the 6. That is... Well, that is no Dr. 6, but...
I'd slam Thorsen and just full face, right? Why even trade that?
Yeah, I think that's fair. I think
like,
that's doable.
For 7 damage... And now he's scared of like Salvage Roar.
Yeah, it might push him to use the swipe instead of being
a lot of pressure.
Able to put down the
No. No. No.
Yeah.
Why?
This I agree with you. This makes me sad. If
Druid
he trades the cat away, that's gonna be ridiculously sad times.
Nah,
he's not thinking. He's not.
I think that's what he's thinking about. I think it is.
He's not.
He shouldn't.
Don't think. Just go face.
Because if he hit face, he would have had 12 damage on board, so he would have threatened lethal with just a Savage Roar. If the Belcher had gone to face.
He's got 7 mana next turn. Not enough for the swipe and force of nature.
So is innervate lore? The swipe is actually pretty good value. You like...
Yeah, you swipe Thorsen, and then Living you can double... It. Oh no, you don't have enough mana to double... Yeah, Living Roots would work. Definitely.
Nope, he's going with the lore. This is too slow, though, right? It's like way too slow.
It's pretty awkward either way, right? One way you're just clearing his board, but you do get.
Okay,
you do get
so
to clear
Savage
off
Roar
the door
top deck wins the game. Not anymore.
Okay. But the Thorsen is just hanging out at full health.
Yeah, I know.
So.
Pretty brutal.
Plus, the slime there will prevent him from just killing off.
Okay, is it time for uproot?
No.
It could be, though.
You don't need to uproot.
I know,
right?
But...
I don't think it changes anything.
Uprooting is so badass.
I don't disagree.
Like, I'm gonna do 10 damage.
I don't
to
disagree,
your face.
But...
Deal with it.
But...
But it plays around Black Knight.
It does, yes. This is true.
Okay, I'm just kidding. I'll try and be more serious.
What
do you think the actual play is then? Taunt or charge form on the cat? Or
I think
rooted.
Charge. If you charge, you get 4 damage in now. It's 19 that you need next turn. Trees plus swipe is 10.
The tree does actually protect Thorsten even more. And nobody plays Black Knight in this meta, right?
I think they could. I mean, people are doing all kinds of weird things, right? Because
are you playing Black Knight?
No.
Yeah.
Oh, just because I am now the representation for
okay,
all
me
Hearthstone
neither.
Players out there.
Okay, but me neither. So
all right, 2 out of 2.
Of all people pulled.
Sounds good. Math not doesn't lie. Math just doesn't lie.
I think even if you do get Black Knight, you're still in okay shape.
Well, you'd
right?
be pretty
that's
sad.
His whole turn. What's that? You'd be a little bit sad, but that's his whole turn. He doesn't have a taunt up, so you still win with a Savage Roar.
5, 6.
No, you just win. You have lethal next turn if he plays Black Knight.
16, 17.
Because you have 10 in hand,
yep.
Plus you can hero power. Yeah. So you're actually not sad if he Black Knights, because you're happy that you won.
Well, maybe
this
you're
is
sad
genius.
Anyway.
This is genius Nyx level, baiting the Black Knight to win. Sylvanas is too late, right? Like, way too late.
Yeah.
Oh, you got the Savage Roar! Max. Is it gonna show the max damage?
Yeah. Well, Savage is at... yeah, I mean, it shows
like,
the max
wow,
damage,
I
but...
You.
Oh, what if he, if he somehow BM'd the swipe onto Sylvanas and then it stole his Ancient of War.
Yeah.
And then he didn't have lethal.
That I think that's the only way, though.
That's the do not BM, boys and girls.
It'd be hard to do, though, wouldn't it?
I mean, like, nobody would do that. They know the risks. Like, nobody
would have.
Do
no,
that.
What he should have done is hit the Ancient of Lore. Into the Sylvanas, right? Then it'd be on 5 health. And then
no, into the lore.
Wins?
I don't, yeah, there's no way to really.
No, not into the lore. Into the no, hits the Ancient of War into the Sylvanas, right? And then I think he still wins. 7 plus 8.
Oh,
no,
I see what
win.
You mean.
No, he still wins.
You can attack with everything else. No.
No, he doesn't still win because
no.
He doesn't have the mana for swipe.
Yeah.
Okay. Why are we talking about
we're
this?
We're like, how do we,
how
what's
do we
the best way to
listen,
maximize
I think about
DM.
This all the time.
I agree. I think it's very important. It's an important skill to have as a Hearthstone player. Absolutely.
Well, not necessarily as a Hearthstone player, but as a streamer, yes.
Yeah, that's fair. You want to provide as much entertainment as possible, and in the scenario that you manage to, manage to screw it up, everyone's entertained anyway, right? So I think it's a win-win situation at that point, you know. In a tournament, you don't want to do that, especially in this kind of format, because, you know, you're disappointing your team, right? As we saw last
only
week,
if
unfortunately.
You screw it up.
That's true. But the risk, right? But
oh,
as
shit.
I'm saying, as a
oh,
streamer,
sorry.
You know, you don't run that risk because if you screw it up, then, you know, people are going to find it really exciting anyway. So it works out.
Totally.
All
okay.
Right. So we've got it tied up once again. Now moving on to the third game of the series, we have Kazi versus
oh my god,
Zebra Thief.
Do you know what this is? This is
what?
The Casino Mage Mirror.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Oh no. I think your client's bugged out again.
Oh, is it?
There's a gap. There's a... Oh no, I think it's okay now.
If I wiggle the cards, I think it's okay.
But you're supposed to have 5 cards.
Oh yeah, you're missing right. You're the 5th card. Oh, yeah, I missed out.
Yeah. So Kazi opting not to play the mirror image. I believe Kazi is actually on C-Star League's list of players to watch out for. Bone Tap also being on that list, but not playing today, so...
Oh, crazy.
Top 10 That's players really to watch. Yeah, looks like he is number 9. John Kazi McIntyre from University of California, Santa Cruz. Oh, Kazi loves the tempo decks. Okay. So...
Okay, I'm back. What did I miss?
You missed Tempo Mage doing Tempo Mage things.
Not much, yeah. Okay.
So,
are you scared to play the Spellslinger here? Like, kind of, right? Because he gets to use his spell first.
That's true.
But I think you just still have to do it. Do you Humility? No.
Yeah, unfortunately... Humility? The deadly poison's gonna be... Well, if Kazi runs a Blinktron, the deadly poison's gonna be awesome.
Insane? It's gonna be insane. Like, deadly poison onto Gorhile just lasts forever.
Well, no. You would want something that increases durability instead at that point, right? Then you can swing at his face twice. That mana worm, though...
He could have coined the Humility onto it, but it would have saved, what, 3 damage? 2 damage? 3 damage? No, only 2 damage.
Yeah, because it still keeps growing, right?
I think the coin has value.
I think at this point, as Kazi, you're just racing to get as much damage in as possible before Zebra has the chance to Flamestrike, if he runs Flamestrike. Okay, the Humility's going to come down this turn.
He's not a zebra, he's actually a zebra thief.
That is true. It's weird when you have names like that, right? It's like, you're tempted to call them by the short form, but here the short form
changes.
Yeah, absolutely changes the,
it's like the opposite
tone of his name. Exactly. Ooh. Interesting. He's gonna buff up his mana worm.
His mana worm is doing God's work, man.
Frostbolt. What do you Frostbolt here?
Frostbolt the 3/4? I think. Oh, he's just not gonna do it. I don't like that. I think with your hand of 4 spells, one of which you can't play, you just go full face, right?
Yeah, I think it's okay to go face. He has Pyroblast, but it's so late. Well, I don't think... Yeah, he probably doesn't.
No, I think he'll get to Pyroblast.
Will he?
Oh, yeah, totally. Like, he's on 5, 6, especially with the Sorcerer's Apprentice still around.
It's not around.
It was.
Yeah. I would right, yes.
Just go full face.
Yeah, that's fair. I think, well, if you go full face, yeah, I think with the Fireball and Frostbolt, that'd probably be enough.
But he has 19 damage in hand right now. So maybe he's just gonna burn.
Well, hey, speaking of Sorcerer Apprentice.
Yeah, he got it back. Sick. Sick plays for days. Oh!
That's okay. The spell, the Flame Waker.
It's the backwards Goldshire Footman.
The backwards.
Ready for action.
Oh,
ooh,
wow.
Do you fireball that? No, I would have fireballed the other one, right?
Yeah, because it deals 2 damage instead of 1 per spell. All right, let's go. I believe in you, Flame Waker. Look at you. Good Flame Waker.
Mode. Do you fireball face?
Why not?
Counter spell? Nah, it doesn't matter.
Just go.
Just do it.
What is
it? Damage. It could be counter spell.
No,
right?
What? Like, can you check it?
Oh, this kind of spell.
Okay. Well, you can't play Deadly Poison, so what can you do? You'd rather the Fireball than the Pyroblast, right? And now you can play Boom next turn without being afraid that it's Mirror Entity. So I think that all works out anyway.
Getting low.
Yeah, we had a player on Wednesday. His name was Getlow. I think he lost his game. So
These guys are playing super fast, by the way.
The Getlow happened. Yeah, I don't really like it
It's
when
hard to
they do
cast.
that.
Like, they are just blitzing through.
Well, it's not just that. It's like there's certain, you know, minute things. Like that game with the, what was it? The poison? That rogue weapon, whatever it
Oh
was.
yeah, poison blade.
Yeah. Things like that, I feel like you really have to think about, right?
Yeah,
Like,
totally. Like,
it
he
kind
ended up
of.
winning anyways, so it's
It
like
just
not a
freaks
big
me
deal.
out, you know, when they're playing that quickly with something like that.
Know,
Ooh.
he finished that game with one charge left, so he actually did miss a damage. I think the game is over though, right? Like, locked out.
No, we're still going. What do you mean?
Yeah, but I mean, like, how is
Oh yeah,
Zebra Thief
Zebra
gonna
Thief
come
can't
back?
come back, right? I
He's
mean,
locked out.
it was essentially just like wait till turn 10 and
Even if he
win.
had two Frost Novas. You know what this is? This is that tutorial mission with Milhouse Mana Storms. Ooh, just wait till I get to 10 mana! Wait till I get to
Okay.
10 mana!
So, oh,
That's BM, he's doing
he's
it! He's
going
doing
for
it!
it. Arcane
Doomsayer!
missiles? No, I would arcane missiles.
No, you put the other bomb into him. What are you doing?
Yeah, that's a misplay.
Oh, missed BM.
That's a misplay right
Oh, he
there.
is doing it!
What?
Yes! Yes!
What?
Yes, he's doing it! I'm so proud of him.
Oh, come
What if he
That's.
gets a counter spell?
No, he
No,
still
no.
has. He can just arcane missiles and power blast the turn after.
Right. Oh my god. That is some stellar BM.
Oh my god.
Whoo! And it's golden too.
Oh my god. Kazi.
Hoo-hoo-hoo!
Kazi,
I told you he
please.
would make it to turn 10.
Oh my god. You were right. I mean,
I was right.
I
Called
was
it.
like, I thought he would have died before turn 10,
Called it.
but I can't argue with that. You are right. He did make it.
Okay, so I've got a 2-1 lead for the Eagles.
No, but I want the slugs to win. No, what is the slugs? Right? Kazi is on the
Oh no,
slugs.
that's right. No, the slugs
Yeah.
are winning. Yes. Wow, caster bias.
I am
Wow,
cheering
your
for the
bias is
slugs.
showing.
I am totally cheering for the slugs. But next game, I'm gonna cheer for cranberries because that is a better name than Prowo.
Prowo?
But cranberries is just a superior name. And I didn't know that cranberry was a band. The cranberries?
The cranberries, yeah.
Yeah, that's a band.
They weren't ever that
Until.
famous, though. They're like pretty small.
Yeah, but somebody linked them in my when I was streaming. So that is how I know about the cranberries. But cranberries, although I do not like the fruit, I think that is a superior battle tag than Prowo.
I've got a bottle of cranberry juice in my fridge. You've just reminded me.
Are
I think I'll
you
mix that up.
do you need a break? Do we need to
No, no, no. No, I'm totally fine. I just like forgot that I owned it.
Okay. Has
It's
it
got a. It doesn't have an interesting story, but it has a mildly interesting story
Okay.
behind it. Last week I was. So in real life, when I'm not casting Hearthstone, I am a professional magician, entertainer, comedian, whatever.
Cool.
Last week I did a gig for some very rich people,
Ah.
and the gig was super boring. And on the way out, I stole some cranberry juice.
What?
So now I have it.
And now you are on record for saying you stole some cranberry juice.
Yeah, I mean, no, it was like for us.
So.
Like we had a little green room, and they give us little, you know,
Yes,
like fruit
yes.
platter and some
But see,
water.
now somebody in chat is
But you're
gonna
not supposed to
track
take it
down.
with you.
They're gonna
But I
track
just
you
totally
down. They're
did.
gonna
It's
track
like
down the gig you did last week. They're gonna
wow, I
find
did not make
those
enough money this
people.
gig. I'm taking these
They're gonna
people's
find
cranberry
those
juice.
people and they're gonna tell them you took their cranberry juice.
Should I tell Cranberry that we're ready to go?
Yes, we can go ahead and get started.
What should I do with it? Maybe I'll get some vodka in there.
That is definitely the typical thing to do with cranberry juice.
That's it.
Alright, so just looking at the lineups here. Actually, what did they play last? It was... Oh, right, Mage.
Last game
Mage.
Was the Mage Mirror. And then we also had a Druid Mirror.
Yeah.
To open. And the middle
Hunter,
game.
Hunter from Santa Cruz. And Warlock.
Versus Warlock, yes.
So.
Man, that Hunter just dummied him, eh?
Yeah. For
just
sure.
Hit him in the face 30 times.
Yeah, like you mentioned, right? Patron was a good deck versus Hunter. And with Patron not really seeing play as much anymore, we're gonna definitely see more face Hunters. The Cancer Hunters and the Cancer Paladins ruling the meta. So far we haven't seen a Paladin.
Oh my god.
Oh, I'm worried.
Did you see what I saw?
I have not seen what you saw yet, but I will see what you saw soon.
Do you get to see the mulligans?
I see a Ysera. Oh my god, they're squishy. Why are they so squishy? No,
okay.
Was there a Leroy Jenkins?
There was a Leroy Jenkins.
Okay. Look at that. Oh, is it my turn for the Spectator client to bug out? Do I have 5 cards?
I don't know, I can't tell. I see 5 cards for Prowl on my client.
Okay,
yes.
In that case, my client bugged out. So, it's kind of more convenient.
I would play the Abusive here and clear the North Shire, because the North Shire is going to draw so many cards. Right? Yeah.
And looks like
this is a tough matchup for Hunter, though.
It is. Coin out the cultist?
Sorry.
The Technician. Yeah, sorry. I did not see that. But it turned yellow. At which point I was like, oh, yes, what a great card to play.
Huffer?
Do you want a Huffer here, though? The Blackwing can kill the Huffer. I'd probably want Misha instead.
I just call the card Huffer. I don't actually think about which one I want.
Here, the Hunter player can choose to play the Haunted Creeper or the Huffer.
No, you don't play the Creeper here, you definitely play a 3-drop.
Yeah,
next turn you play Creeper Hero Power.
I'm just saying, like, you know, you're just calm. As opposed to...
Oh, you got the Misha!
Yeah, I think the Misha's the best case here.
You know what that card should say? Just, like, summon a Huffer, unless Misha is better. Just fix the text.
Did you just play the Cultist here?
Yeah. Cultist, do you swing? Do you swing? Maybe just cultist pass.
Yeah.
Misha's pretty good.
I would probably pass.
There's also, like, you could also power word shield to cycle and then hit the Misha and then heal it, but that's not that good.
That is the other option I was thinking, but unfortunately doesn't kill it. A Velen's would have been nice here.
A Velen's chosen.
Well, I think you could. Do you hit? I don't.
Do you swing?
No, because then the Abusive can kill it, right?
Right. Yeah, exactly.
It kills off the Misha, but it doesn't really... Yeah, I don't think that helps.
I played the Spiders. Spiders, shoot 'em. Full face.
Shoot 'em.
Spiders, Hero Power, full face. Like, you got Leroy Jenkins in there, man. You're not... You're on a clock. You know?
Yeah, I don't think... And, you know, with the taunt there, especially.
I don't think it's good to miss that Hero Power. Because you're going to miss another Hero Power.
That is
He wanted to trade to protect Misha, I guess?
No, he didn't. He just went peace.
No, he hovered the Abusive over the Cultist. Yeah. Pain is a pretty nice pickup. Although, like, you don't...
You're not gonna pay the Abusive.
You might. I guess you just heal your face, right?
Consider...
What else would you do?
Yeah. Would you consider shielding the Cultist instead? Because that way that stays up, right? This is just like a large Blackwing Corruptor now, as opposed to having two minions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think your thing is clearly better. Oh, he is gonna pain.
I guess it's not that same. Bad to paint it's it. The same as healing your face, but the minion's gone.
But the minion's gone, exactly. But, even though it's not that, but it's not much value in it, right?
Yeah, there could be other things to pain instead, I think.
Do you hold the bow here? Oh! What are you doing? Don't trade into it! Are you crazy?
Yeah, never trade unless it's something that has more damage.
Trade? No.
The only way I would trade that is if it was like a Wolf Rider that got Glaive Zooka, and I would trade that with a Blackwing Corruptor. Right? That's a situation where I would trade. But other than that, I really don't
even
see
it. Even then, I probably wouldn't trade. I would just put the 4 damage on his face.
That's fair.
Would you hold the bow here?
Yeah, that's fair. I would not. He doesn't have any secrets in... Oh, he does have the Scientist out, but he's not going to trade the Scientist. His opponent might trade the... I would... Yeah, just go for it. Twilight Guardian here, I think. I guess you're not really afraid of a Unleash at the moment, so the Twilight Whelp is down.
Sick plays for days. Get him!
What secret is that?
That is an explosive trap.
I guess that makes sense. The super aggressive...
That is the trap I would put in, into my first sector.
Yeah, for sure. It deals damage to face, obviously. You can't put Freezing Trap in there. Freezing Trap doesn't even do damage to anything. Yeah. Why would you possibly play that?
So, Kill Command wins, because he's got the spiders in hand.
Well, you Blackwing that, you heal yourself.
Yeah, but...
Or...
He's still got Kill Command. That Kill Command is a winning top deck.
That's...
That is a...
That is
not play,
the
it?
Way to win.
Corruptor heal. So now Quickshot kills him too. And Wolf Rider kills him. And the other Arcane Golem kills him. And Bow kills him.
At the same time.
Got him. Got him. Killed that nerd.
Well, the thing is, it didn't matter either way for him here.
Sure, it didn't matter, but it gave him more outs though.
Yeah,
because
the
before Kilgaman was the only top deck.
That is true, but the problem is the priest didn't have taunts up at this point, mm-hmm. and it's hard. Like, he would have to Holy Nova to be able to really get out
of
range
Naru.
Of anything.
Light of the Naru. I don't know if he runs it.
Yeah. It's very hard to get out of range. So once again, we see a Hunter winning the
Hunter
game.
Hunter doing Hunter things, baby.
Indeed, and that will bring it to...
Ace match!
Another ace match. You are lucky. This is the first night that we've had.
Oh, really? This is great.
Yeah, two best of fives. Two games that actually went to game five. It was a 5-3, 5-3, and then 4-3, I think. So.
This is exciting.
You get the value cast. You get the most games for.
Unfortunately, I'm not being paid by the hour, so...
Or by number of games, right?
Or at all. So.
Yes, there is that.
So, in that sense, it's not value. In that sense, it's anti-value.
That is true. You are stuck with me for a little while longer, then. Terribly sorry about that.
Oh, stuck. Aw.
All right, so on to our second ace match of the night. It will be Add-On 1-2-3 versus Isaac Kaz.
Isaac Kaz. I think Kaz is short for something.
Will the macho slug win it out for Santa Cruz, or will the eagle swoop down, pick up the slug, and kill it?
Okay.
So, looks like we have a Paladin for Add-On versus the Warrior of Isaac Kaz.
What is Isaac's
Isaac Kaz.
Gamer tag? I don't have him.
Mm. So it looks like we have a secret paladin, probably a more mid-range version, or actually, hard to say. Secret paladin from add-on versus the warrior of Isaac. I have a feeling I'm going to see another patron warrior.
It's a fatigue warrior, I think, with the bashes.
I think bashes.
Armor
is
up,
okay.
Armor up, armor up. Just a card. Tank up, tank up. I'm out of cards.
Tank up. It's hard to say at the moment what it is. I think Bash is a fine card to have, like as opposed to a shield block or something. You know, it kills something off, which sort of makes up for the fact that it only heals you for 3 instead of 5. You miss out on the card draw, but...
No, you take both. That's what I'm talking about.
That's true. Yeah. You can take all of that. Well, the other thing is it also doesn't draw a card, so you get to fatigue later. You know, if we end up in one of those Resident Sleeper double control warrior games.
Oh, the thing is that you can be ahead of them in cards, but you have 80 health because you've been tanking up all game. Mm-hmm. And then you just beat them because you have so much removal, right? You got your standard removal package, plus you got your 4 weapons, plus 2 brawls, and then bash. Like, bash is really good with slam. Like, slam bash gets you to 5 damage. Or, like, bash fiery war axe lets you clear the druid of the claw taunt form. Like, there's a ton of really good stuff there.
I like that. The bash package.
The other acolyte?
Yep.
This is not your standard super aggressive... this is not your standard super aggressive secret paladin either. He's playing Dr. Boom and some shredders, which means he might also be playing Tyrion.
The other interesting...
And Tyrion is crazy value.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, Tyrion's crazy value to begin with against any deck, but against Warrior, definitely.
No, especially against Warrior, because they have a hard time getting the 1 damage on it to do the execute. And same thing with Shield Slam, right? You have to pop the Divine Shield and then Shield Slam it.
Yep.
And that's really hard for Warriors to do.
Absolutely.
He's getting a ton of cards, though, off these Acolytes. This is, like, well above average.
Well, he has Revenge and Execute and Bash, so he can deal with Tyrion. I don't know about anything else, but he can deal with Tyrion.
Right. Where is...
Anne picks up
his weapons.
BGH.
Where are his weapons?
I don't know.
You have at least 1 axe, and then probably 2
death bites. Yeah. Oh, speaking of Tyrion.
Hello.
Brawl also works out versus Tyrion. The interesting thing here to know... Add-on has 2 redemptions. Usually people only run 1 redemption, and I find Secret Paladin, you know, especially because it's a new deck, people are still trying to figure it out. It's a deck that's very hard to fit extra cards in, so I'm pretty curious what he took out to fit in that second redemption.
Maybe 1 Competitive Spirit. Competitive Spirit is hard to get value on.
Well, you only run 1, you run 1 Competitive, 1 Redemption, and 1 Repentance. So, I don't know, maybe like a True Silver?
I think it's okay, either
way. Or maybe cutting out the 1 drops, like no Secret Keeper, no Zombie Chow, nothing.
Do you think he's gonna brawl here? I don't think you should brawl here. I think get a bigger brawl.
Yeah, it's not time to brawl yet.
Just cycle that shield block.
And armor up.
Oh,
he is going
what?
To brawl.
No guts! You only take 3 damage off the board. You only took 1 damage off the board.
Yeah.
He took 0 damage off the board because the brawl gave the Trog 1 extra attack.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a... Oh, no.
That is not the kind of brawl you want to see.
Well, that definitely shows he's running 2 brawls, though.
I think
this is
so.
Really brutal. Why?
I would agree. And I don't think it's even that bad to get low on health, because he has Revenge in hand, so Revenge
right.
basically clears out all those little guys that we saw.
Sylvanas?
I think Sylvanas is okay here. There's so many guys, but he's just gonna go face, right? This is not the turn to shield block.
He's feeling it. I think he's scared.
Hello, Trogzor.
Oh, this is really brutal. That's a lot
he
of...
can revenge. It'll clear off the shield.
Whoa! What?
Okay.
That's weird. How did that become damaged? That's not damaged.
Yes, it is.
Is that a glitch?
It was from Redemption.
Yeah, but it redeems as a 2-1.
Yes, so it's damaged.
Oh, that counts? I thought it was like equality, because if you equality someone, you can't execute it.
Yeah, no. It comes back damaged.
Weird. I don't think I've ever seen that. I must have seen it.
So here, he can...
Gotta armor up, man. Every turn. Tyrion is gonna ruin his day, though.
No, but if he plays out his Sylvanas, Tyrion...
Yeah, but Tyrion's gonna hit him twice.
That is true. I think it's okay. Once he has the Sylvanas out, Tyrion can't suicide himself, right? And in any way, like Tyrion's very hard to off. So the Sylvanas would take care of that.
So Sylvanas is definitely coming down. Do you revenge here or no?
I think you just armor up.
Yeah, no.
You don't want to pop the shield. Like, you just want to leave Tyrion as healthy as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And then
you want to maximize your chances of grabbing it.
You could revenge would not be a bad idea because you get rid of the boom bot.
Yeah, so... but he'll play other things. Like, you want the revenge on the turn that your Sylvanas is active because he's going to hero power at least just to give you more targets.
Yes, you are right. Avenge also not a good idea here, then. The Shredder is also not a good idea, so the Sylvanas actually being quite the nuisance here.
I think it's Hero Power, Avenge, Shredder, right?
And just...
And then slam him in the face. There is an argument to not hit him in the face to play around of Revenge, but I don't think anybody plays around Revenge.
But no, this is good because Revenge will kill off the Shredder, so you get less value, right? Because
the Boombot. What if the Boombot hits Sylvanas? Because the Death Rattle order is Boombot, Sylvanas, Shredder. So actually, this is the best. If the Boombot hits the Sylvanas, Sylvanas is guaranteed Tyrion. Because the Sylvanas will trigger before. No.
What's wrong with this? Yeah, this is fine.
No, but it's a 50-50 this way.
I see what you mean. I see.
Yeah,
but Sylvanas can still hit Tyrion, right?
Yeah, but you get two 50-50s.
This is... I see what you mean. I get it now.
Yeah, before he would have had the coin toss for the Boombot to hit Sylvanas, and then the coin toss again.
Okay, yeah, so you're right. The Armorsmith...
Ah!
Ooh. That might have just... Yeah.
So now it was a 50-50 plus a 25.
Yeah, you're right. That would have.
It's not quite a 50-50 because I think that would have. That the Boombot does one damage, so the odds are not exactly that. But he would have been around like 70% chance to get the Tyrion if he didn't put the Armorsmith down first.
Wow.
He's getting low. So I guess the play is Baron. You know what? He might still win, because he has two Shield Maidens, which cancels out two charges.
Yeah.
It's gotta be Baron, right? And then you're just like, God, I really hope that's not... Oh, no, he's already seen two Redemptions, so he's okay. Paladin has no cards, man. This is still very winnable for the Warrior.
Yeah, I mean, he's got all the big cards. Ooh, well, there's still Mysterious Challenger.
Dude, check out this juggle.
Oh my god. Oh.
That's so unfair. Like, it really is.
Oh.
That's for the game, don't hit. Right? Because if he misses, then his board dies. Oh, that's so brutal. It's so brutal.
Oh, man.
Oh, Alex. You're fine. He's got an Alex, and then he can have like Grom.
I might have Grommed on that.
Yeah, probably should have Grommed.
Grom and kill the knife, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. He's getting decently low.
He can't brawl. Well, he can brawl, but if he brawls, he misses an armor up.
What do you mean? Oh, I see.
He can Deathbite and Shield Maiden. Actually, I think that's the best.
Deathbite the Knife Juggler?
Yeah, Deathbite the Knife Juggler, and then Shield Maiden, which would put him at 12, right? So he dies to Consecrate. He could Brawl, but that doesn't... Like, he can't armor up then. He can Grommish Hero Power. The best chance of survival is Shield Maiden. You die to the least number of things.
No, because if... Okay, this is
well,
good.
Now he dies to Blessing of Kings. Nope. So he dodged it.
And now Paladin draws these very slow one damage. I mean, one secret per turn. You have to Grom this turn, right?
I don't think you do. If you do Grom, what do? Grom him in the face? If he swings the Ashbringer, then you for sure Alex yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
But I think you could Deathbite face Shield Maiden.
Ooh, a Sludge Belcher. Yeah, Deathbite Shield Maiden, I think, is the best.
I think the best play is Deathbite Shield Maiden, yeah. But well, you don't hit a creature.
Yeah, you definitely don't hit a creature.
Are you scared about Noble Sack?
No, because you'd still have enough health, right, with the Shield Maiden?
He's just going to armor up. Armor! Please!
Or he's going to play
the Sludge
Belcher,
please armor. Oh, why then?
Deathbite to face?
I don't know.
Okay. Oh, the mistake.
That's not that bad, actually, because you can put the Deathbite into something and then Alex yourself, and you're, like, maximizing the Alex value. Like, next turn, I mean.
Yeah,
so it's, like, not that bad.
That's fair.
But I think you just put the armor up, man, and you get some shields. You live forever.
Alright, so Adon's gonna use up his last Ashbringer charge here.
The Mysterious Challenger is gonna get him really close to fatigue.
Is it though? He's still got... No, he's got 12 cards.
He's only got one secret left.
He's...
That's a bit unfortunate, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay. No, it makes sense. He's played one Redemption, one Repentance. Noble Sack. Two Avengers are gone. He's got an Avenge up and a Noble Sacrifice up. So he'll
nice
proc
combo.
That, yeah, for sure.
And I think it was a mistake to not swing the Deathbite last turn, because now he can't Whirlwind his Grommish. Wait, did he just throw the game?
Why?
Because he just put 5 damage onto the board, basically. So he loses now to Blessing of Kings. Or True Silver.
Mm-hmm. That is not what you want to see. That's the problem with this deck, right? You're just like...
I know, this is what I tell people when they're like complaining
about
it.
Once you survive past Tyrion...
You have 12 one-drops, or you have 11 one-drops.
Yeah. You just gotta survive past Tyrion.
Mm-hmm. And this is the slow version, too. The fast version runs out of gas even faster.
Yeah. Oh, man. This is a nail-biter.
But I think with Alex in hand, how do you lose?
That's fair. But he could have lost there, right?
He could have lost there, yeah, totally.
Yeah.
Like,
there's
these
True
top Silver,
decks.
Yeah. Gormok. No Gormok. Almost Gormok.
He should trade.
I've been playing Gormok. Gormok is so cool. But really bad.
He should trade here, right? Or would you go face?
As
I guess,
the,
yeah, your opponent trades, so you go
Paladin?
Face.
Yeah, no, you definitely full face him. Lethal!
10,
I didn't
11,
even see the counter
15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Yeah, it's 19 damage.
Got him.
Oh my god! That's a really good game to end the series on as well.
That was really swingy too, yeah.
Oh my
These
gosh.
These are great games. A couple of questionable decisions. I don't know if it was strictly wrong, but scary for me anyways.
Yeah, for sure.
But turns out it doesn't matter. Turns out gromming him in the face is still a viable strategy.
Yep. And there we go. The warrior taking out the paladin.
So, congrats. Congrats to the eagles.
Looks like the eagle have
majestically
crushed the slug. As nature would have it, right? Eagles beat slugs in nature.
Right.
So that happens, unfortunately. I don't know how to feel about this, right? Because one, I'm of course cheering for the slugs, but can I really cheer for a secret paladin over a control warrior?
It wasn't the super cancer one. I mean, he was playing some shredders, he had some other things in there. But you know what? I think those changes cost him, because if he was playing a fast version of that deck, I think he would have killed him in time.
Maybe. Yeah, there were definitely...
Because think about the warrior was really scared the whole time, right? Like, he brawled on three creatures. Remember his first brawl on those?
Yeah, who knows? I'm curious what would happen if he didn't brawl on those. There were quite a few unlucky spots, though, for add-on as well. You know, the spot where the brawl had a 50% chance of leaving him with a 1-1. If he had the knife juggler or Lotheb instead, he probably would have won. Not drawing the blessings, that's like
one or two cards. He also got lucky not losing his Tyrion, though. Remember that luckiness?
Yeah, but it was also a potentially
also a minor
misplay. Yeah.
Potential misplay, yeah.
That was a really cool turn, though. Like, if he really thought
really
about
cool
the shredder,
turn.
That would have been really sick.
But that is that. So congrats to the Eagles, and also congrats to the... I can't remember the other team's name now.
St.Johns. Yes. Johnny Boy taking it home for St.Johns University in our first series.
Nailed it. St.Johns, yes. And shout out to that crew as well. And commiserations to everyone who came up short. Just barely, though, right? These are all really close games.
Hey, well, you know what? Everybody got to play today, so at least there's that.
Yeah, it was nice.
Everybody gets a participation award. You know.
Okay. Yeah.
All right.
Thanks to everybody for watching. Because it is definitely more fun in chat when there's a chat.
Absolutely.
And I don't know. I don't have anything else to add, so take it away.
It is casted here by Lucia Fireball and Eden with 6 N's.
Yeah.
We have the Twitter information up for you if you are interested. Hearthstone will be resuming next Wednesday. I believe Nomo Dogen will be back by then, but thank you very much for joining us, Eden. It was a pleasure having you here today.
Yes, totally. Pleasure to be here.
And we'd like to thank our sponsors, Twitch and Blizzard, for sponsoring. And, well, they're both integrally a part of the cast and the game as well, so without either of them, this would literally not be happening. So that is all we have for you tonight. Have a good night, have a good weekend, and we will see you next week.
Have a great night, everybody.
You.